Dear students, today we are going to discuss the topic interconversion of states between different states of matter. Chapter 1, Matter in Our Surroundings, Class 9, Chemistry. The interconversion of states means solid to liquid, liquid to gas, gas to liquid, liquid to solid, solid to gas, or gas to solid. This is all we say the interconversion of states. Now, states can be interconverted, means solids can be converted into liquid or liquid into gas and vice versa. States can be interconverted by the application of either temperature or pressure. So, in this video, I am going to discuss about the application of temperature on the interconversion of states. These are the particles of the solid which are very close to each other. Now what will happen when we heat any solid substance? When we heat any solid substance, then the heat energy gets converted into kinetic energy. Now what is this kinetic energy? The energy possessed by any body by virtue of its state of motion. In simpler words, we can say this is the energy which allow any particle to move from its mean position. So what will happen when we heat any solid in which the particles are already very closer to each other? This heat energy is getting converted into kinetic energy. Therefore, the particles start vibrating from the mean position. For example, let us consider these are the two atoms of solid. They are very closer to each other. When we give the heat energy, finally get converted into kinetic energy, the particles start vibrating like this and start colliding with each other. And when the collision increases, the void increases. Void means the intermolecular spaces or the interatomic spaces. As the void increases, the particles move apart from each other. And finally, the solids get converted into the liquid state. The solid get converted into the liquid state. Now what will happen if we again heat the liquid? If we heat the liquid, same process will take place again. The particles of the liquid gains energy in the form of heat, convert the energy into kinetic energy, and due to kinetic energy, they show Brownian movement. They start moving randomly, they start moving apart from each other and finally get converted into the gaseous state. It means when we heat any solid, the solid get converted into liquid. When we heat liquid, it gets converted into gas. This is all because of this conversion. Now this process is called as fusion. The process of converting the solid into liquid is called fusion. And this process is called as vaporization. The process by which when we heat any liquid, it gets converted into the gaseous state. That process is called as vaporization. So, simply we can say when we heat, the solid gets converted into liquid. Again, when we heat liquid, it gets converted into gas. This process is called as fusion, and this is called as vaporization. Now, what will happen if we cool the gas? Cooling means taking out the energy. If we take out the energy from the molecules of the gas, it means we are reducing the kinetic energy. So the particles of the gas, which are very apart from each other, they come closer to each other. And when the particles of the gas come closer to each other, then gas get converted into liquid. And this process is called as condensation. Now, again we are going to cool the liquid. When we cool the liquid, the particles which are already closer to each other come somewhat more closer to each other and they stuck off. And finally the liquid gets converted into solid. This process is called as solidification. Now let us summarize the processes. When we heat the solid, the heat energy get converted into kinetic energy, due to which the molecules start moving apart from each other and solid get converted into liquid state. Then when we heat liquid, same process will take place and liquid get converted into gas. Similarly, when we cool the gas, cooling means we are drawing the energy, we are taking out the energy. So when we are taking out the energy from the gas molecules, they come closer to each other and gas finally get converted into the liquid state. This is called as condensation process. And similarly, when we cool the liquid, again the molecules of the liquid comes closer to each other and finally the liquid get converted into the solid state. And this process is called as solidification. There is one another type of process. In which we see that solid get directly converted into gas on heating. When we heat the solid, not all the solids, there are few solids. When we heat those solids, they get directly converted into gas without being getting converted into the intermediate liquid state. Such process is called as sublimation. Okay, so sublimation is a process. It is a physical process according to which when we heat any solid and solid get directly converted into gaseous state. Now, when we cool the gas, the gas directly is getting converted into the solid state without coming into the intermediate liquid state. This process is called as deposition. So solid into gas directly upon heating is called sublimation, and gas into solid directly upon cooling is called deposition. The most common examples of the solids which undergo sublimation are camphor, ammonium chloride, iodine is also a sublime substance. Okay. Naphthalene. So these are the following substances which show sublimation. So all the solids which undergo the process of sublimation are called as sublime solids. So these solids are called as sublime solids. That's all for this video. Thank you very much.